Peace for Families helps victims of domestic violence and sexual abuse. Today, they're celebrating those who have overcome and also reaching out to those who still need help. Joining us this morning is Michelle Coleman, Executive Director of Peace for Families. Good morning. Thanks so much for being here.
Well, good morning. Thank you for having me.
This run today is called the Survivor's Run. How does a public event like this, putting these people out in the public eye, help them overcome what they've been through?
What's interesting about the fact that we call it the Survivor's Run is that the people who are running, you will never know they're survivors. Mm. Domestic violence and sexual violence happens to everyone. It impacts every family, every educational strata, social strata. So all through our group today, you'll see individuals, you'll see doctors and lawyers and people who work at McDonald's, and they'll just be interacting with each other. And there will be many of them. Over a quarter of our runners will be survivors of these violent attacks.
Coming together in groups obviously helps support them as well. But Peace for Families also focuses on prevention.
Absolutely. One of the things that we want to do is eradicate violence in Placer County. Mm-hmm. And though we provide intervention services for people who have been hurt, we provide strategies and training to prevent people from being hurt. We self-defense classes.
Mm-hmm. You just had one.
Absolutely. Yeah. And they will be every month. We'll have a self-defense class. We do training in classrooms for young people to teach them how to keep themselves safe. And we're also working on a new project where we'll be teaching people how to be safe bystanders, how if they see something going on, what they can do to prevent the violence from happening and still keep themselves safe.
You mentioned different workshops that you have. Are these free for people?
Absolutely.
Okay.
They're free.
Wonderful.
It's all about the people in Placer County understanding how they can take care of themselves and the people in their lives. I don't think there's anyone that you approach that can say, I don't know anyone who has experienced domestic or sexual violence in my life.
And I can imagine a lot of times, most of the time, for people to come forward, it can be pretty tough. So how does your organization help people when they want to get in touch with somebody and say that they need help?
Okay. Well, the first step the easiest step is our confidential 24-hour crisis mm-hmm. line. That's 800-575-5253. 24 hours a day, we have counselors on that line who will walk you through a process. So you get to decide what you want to do. Do I actually need to go to our safe house
sure.
to get away from violence? Do I need to call the police and get the police involved? Or do I need to access the counseling services so I can figure out what I want to do?
Okay, let's give more people information on the run now. The Survivor's Run is taking place this morning. Registration is at 8. The run starts at 9. It's at Miners Ravine Trail at Sculpture Park in Roseville. And for more information, there is a link on our website. Just go to kcra.com. Michelle Coleman with Peace for Families, thanks so much for being with us this morning.